Welcome to Warn. Today's news is: building an impenetrable defense shield, impact of the S-400 to checkmate Pakistan. India and Russia agreed on a landmark deal on 15/10/16 that will see the Russians supply the Indian armed forces with 5 S-400 strategic surface to air missile units. This deal will be the single greatest augmentation of air defense in India since the acquisition of the SA-3 in the late 1960s. To be fair, this is just part of a required massive modernization of the Indian military's air defense capabilities that has several tiers and will see all civilian and military radars in the country integrated into one massive all-pervasive net. The key indigenous and imported components of this upgradation are 1. Up to 5 Israeli green pine and indigenous swordfish long-range tracking radar systems, 2, indigenous ballistic missile defense system consisting of Prithvi air defense and Ashwin air defense interceptor missiles designed to protect our cities from ballistic missiles. A second tier of interceptors called AD1 and AD2 are in development as well. 3. 5 units of S-400 battle space protection systems that will function as a strategic LRSAM and also be used to deny PAF its own airspace if required. 4. Numerous Indo-Israeli 90 km range MRSAM units that will replace and augment the 60s era S-200 and SA-3 units. 5. Numerous indigenous Akash deep aerostat radar systems proving a bird's eye view into enemy airspace. 6. Numerous indigenous Akash missile units that will form the numerical backbone of air defense at our air bases. 7. India has inducted at least 18 Israeli Spider SRSAM units and there is a high possibility of more units coming in as well. 8. Upgradation of Bofors and ZSUA guns, 2000 plus guns will be eventually upgraded. Apart from these, the Strela, OSA, Pachora and KUB anti-aircraft missile batteries deployed by the Indian military are being upgraded as well. A simultaneous program shall see the induction of a large number of modern SPAAG, QRSAM and MANPADS as well. Of all these systems, however, it is the S-400 that is most feared by all our foes as it comes with a reputation as a ruthless hunter of enemy aircraft at ranges almost all other SAM systems would fail at. A S-400 system consists of 4 core components: the 30K6E battle management system, comprising the 55K6E command post and 91N6E Big Bird/N6L6 acquisition radar, up to 698ZH6E fire units, each comprising a 92N6E gravestone multimode engagement radar, up to 12 5P85 Southeast 2/5P85TE2TELs, each tel armed with up to 448N6E2/E3 missiles, a complement of SAM rounds, comprising arbitrary mixes of the 48N6E, 48N6E2 and 48N6E3. The 30TS6E logistical support system, comprising missile storage, test and maintenance equipments. Special customers like India can hope to get the 400 km 40N6E interceptor missiles as well. However, as on date there is no confirmation of this interceptor making its way here. AS-400 system uses 6 types of missiles as interceptors to target enemy aircraft, cruise missiles, drone and ballistic missiles. These are: 1. The 400 km, rumored to be up to 450 km, range 40N6 surface-to-air strategic interceptor designed primarily to target ballistic missiles and strategic airborne platforms like bombers, AWACS, Elland aircraft, tankers and transporters. This missile is reported to have an intercept speed of up to 17,000 km/h. That means even an F-16 BLK-50 in clean configuration will find it impossible to get away from a 40N6 coming at it from 300 to 350 km away. 2. The 200 km and 250 km range 48N6E2 and 48N6E3 that is primarily designed to hunt all types of targets traveling at up to 4800 m/s. 3. there are two shorter-ranged interceptors called the 9M96E and 9M96E2 that guard against aerial threats at up to 40 and 120 km ranges respectively. The S-400 has the potential to completely revolutionize any future conflict with Pakistan by denying the Pakistani Air Force the ability to operate freely within its own airspace. A single fire unit deployed near Jammu can control Pakistani airspace all the way to Peshawar. Three such fire units controlled by a single battle management unit should be able to control all of Pakistani airspace east of the Indus. This has grave implications for Pakistan as a nation. Consider the fact that Pakistan is only some 500 kilometers wide on average, and the effect of a S-400 controlling 300 to 350 kilometers of that airspace, deployed 50 to 100 kilometers behind the border, will be devastating to the Pakistan Air Force. By the same paradigm, this system practically guarantees that Indian strike forces engaging in a shallow 50 to 100 kilometers cold start type strike should be relatively well protected against Pakistani airstrikes and missile attack. The implications are obvious. Any future transgression by Pakistan post the deployment of S-400 class units may see Pakistan dismembered by numerous Indian armored and artillery thrusts working under a S-400 missile defense umbrella. Also, no S-400 will be deployed alone. They will work in tandem with PHALCON and DRDO AWACS, other Indian radars including the LRTR units mentioned earlier, and aerostats. Even in the Eastern Theater, a single S-400 unit deployed in Arunachal will cover 3 of 5 major Chinese airbases in Tibet. Such a unit will also provide the entire Northeast with a protective umbrella against Chinese missiles and aircraft. At first thought, one would assume that India has every incentive to station a number of S-400 systems, potentially up to 3, in fairly close proximity to Pakistan. If equipped with the 40N6 missile, grounding the S-400 in the heart of Indian Punjab would enable India to stifle the Pakistan Air Force, PAF, from flying in key areas in its central command theater, which is responsible for protecting Lahore, the country's inland economic hub and second largest city. Similar positioning and results can be had in the south, in terms of Karachi, and the north, in terms of Kashmir. India need not deploy the S-400 in that manner, at least permanently, though the incentive to preempt Pakistan from utilizing its aerial assets, which carry a number of the country's preemptive standoff range munitions, is certainly there and should not be dismissed. In fact, the risk of India taking such a course is something Pakistani defense planners would be wise to acknowledge and work to address. India is slated to get 5 S-400 systems starting in 2020. Further details on the number of launchers etc. remains classified. However, extrapolating with the Chinese S-400 purchase for 6 firing batteries and a rumored 3 battle management systems for some $3 billion, the Indian deal should consist of at least 8 to 10 firing batteries and associated systems. Considering that each firing battery can have up to 12 launchers, and noting that the Russians have deployed only 8 launchers in each of their batteries, we can safely assume that India should get at least 80 launchers as part of 10 firing units controlled by 5 battle management systems. Suffice it to say, the S-400 will be the tip of an extremely powerful and long spear that will thrust into the heart of the PAF in any future conflict post its deployment. Thanks for watching. I hope you like this news. Please share your views in comment box. Please like and share this video. Press subscribe button and bell for auto update to you regarding my channel World Action and Reaction News. Warn.